Hey bosses, how are we all doing? Tali Brown here, and I am just doing a quick update on the Boss Challenge. So if you have been following me on my journey, you know that for a few months now, I have been going on this positivity cleanse. So I would ask you to have a look at my first videos. These are old videos. I'm not ashamed of them, but it would give you some grounding on what Boss Challenge is about. So I want to make this really, really short and simple, and I want to do an overview on what's been really going on. Let's just get right into it, right? So first things first, so the past few videos that have been going on, it's been all about what's been going on locally. People have been getting in touch with me about the Boss Challenge and how that has been impacting them. And honestly, I actually just thought it's something for myself, and I thought, let me hold myself accountable to it by actually recording it. And if anyone wants to listen, they can listen. But I wasn't actually expecting so many people to be actually getting in touch with me and asking me questions. These are people that, you know, going to events, you know, have found me on social media and have DM'd me. The more I talk about it, the more people want to understand. Not many people have, you know, seen it, but the fact that they enjoy the concept, it's just humbling to me. And it's actually made me want to take it a step further. What I've decided is that making the Boss Challenge a more official thing, and I know I did say that I was going to do it for a year, but let's just see how this can keep going, you know. So far, it's been exciting, I'm learning, and I'm loving it. You know, it's just been refreshing. So, I have a project that I'm working on, actually a few projects more that I've actually joined in. I can't actually wait to let you all know about it because I'm so excited. Like, when I was first informed about it, I was so scared. I was so scared that I was like, me? Like, yeah, I really didn't think in a million years that, you know, it would be me being given such an opportunity. But you can't say no to some of these things, and you don't actually know what it's going to lead you to. Leading from that, okay, why don't we go and recap? It is 1st of July. And we're back to the drawing board. Okay, here we have my vision board for 2017. From everything that I've done, quite a lot, I think. Okay, so working out. Guys, I have been running for the bus, but at the same time, I've been trying to work out. I don't have my six pack yet because it hasn't been deep, that kind of like workout. But I'm there, you know, only for the bold. Guys, can I just say something? When you're on the tube, okay, those people that are on subways, trains, London, where it's like really congested, you know, sometimes, but you know, when you see that empty seat, you have to be aggressive, okay? That's what I've been doing. I'm on the train and I'm like, you taking that seat? No? Okay, I'm sitting myself down. That's what I've literally been doing. Before that, I'd be like, oh, let me just wait. Let me look around. Is anyone else that's vulnerable than me? I'm thinking, well, I'm tired. I want to sit down. If nobody wants to have a seat, I take the seat. So I have become more bold. Global travel. I haven't done that too much apart from when I went to the States in March for spring break. I haven't really gone anywhere, but going on holiday soon, so that's even more exciting. Dietary. So with my new job, it's in central London, and I'm having to commute in, and you get drawn into this whole street food scene and the restaurants, and you're just thinking, oh, I just want to eat, you know. But they've got Itsu, which is like the love of my life at the moment, and I'm trying not to spend because I'm trying to save money. But I have been really, really healthy, so I'm really, really glad about that. I am actually going to start bringing more fruit snacks, soups and stuff, putting my whole self out there. That's what I've been doing, going to these events, networking. Guys, when I tell you networking is so important, I mean it. I'm about to show you, okay? And so Boss Challenge definitely has given me the courage to speak up to some of these people, because sometimes in life we don't realize that what we want in life is actually right in front of us. We just have to take that one step forward into our opportunities, and sometimes it means giving up on something. In the past, I don't know how many weeks, months, I've been meeting people that actually fit, or those actual people that I need to talk to, to help me to where I need to go to actually get to the next level. So it's just, it's amazing, guys. I really don't know how to explain this, but it's amazing. Powerful ambition. I'm feeling like that. I'm feeling like that. And I'm watching some of these people, like I'm watching the vloggers, and I'm feeling inspired. And I'm thinking, yeah, do you know what? I want to make it to the BET Awards as well, you know. So what do I have to do? Network, attend events, more of the YouTube videos, but actually work more on the things for myself, because it's all about me being uniquely me and standing out. So that's pretty much what I'm going to be doing. And keeping life simple, that's all I've been doing. I really don't have time for complications. I really don't. And you can't afford to go through drama. You can't afford to try and please other people, because when you please other people, you end up losing yourself, and that's how you end up spiraling down to being that depressed and full of anxiety and all of that. Like, you really don't want that in life. And so what I would say to you guys is to write down what you want to achieve this year. And this is what I've been doing, is that I've got my notebook, the one that I had from earlier on, from when I started vlogging. I've been writing goals, and so for the week I'll say, right, I want to achieve this, and that's what I work towards. Just 10 minutes to an hour, that's all it takes. If you've got more time, do it, but it could do a lot for you. It all adds up, and it's consistency. Just looking, how can I get to the next goal? What is it that I can do right now that will kind of lead me? Don't think too hard, just think very, very basic. You know, like, I want to travel. Okay, what do you do? Right, get a destination, see how much it will cost, save the money. How can I save it? Look at what you're spending it on. Am I spending it on, like, shopping? Am I spending it on food, going out? Are there some of, like, my responsibilities, like my phone bill? Is there a cheaper alternative that I can get? Things like that. When do I want to go? And set yourself deadlines. Work towards it. 10 minutes a day. That's all it takes. And I'm always thinking about my dreams. When it comes to my blogs, I'm writing on the way, going to work. Then I post it whenever it is ready, because I know that someone out there will benefit from it. That's exactly what you need to do. So I'm going to leave it here. So, little spoiler, I'm going to be starting a new segment. I haven't got a title for it yet. It's going to be one-to-one interviews with some people about how they've made it. And it will relate to the boss challenge, because boss challenge is all about being beautiful, optimistic, or opportunist, self-assured, and be the sister. Make sure you follow me on social media. That's Tali Brown on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook if you want, and I will leave my email down below if you have any questions. That's talibrown@gmail.com, and I'd love to hear your stories as well. Make sure you like and you subscribe, but also I want you to share this video, because this is a movement, the boss movement, okay? So let's all work together, all right, sisters and the brothers, because I know some of you are watching, okay? So I love you guys. I shall see you all later. Bye.